I'm making this about the blowdown kit for, or blowdown tube that you have to have to meet NHRA tech. Now, originally I bought a hardline blowdown tube, but when I mounted the bottle in here and found out where it was laying, there's no way to bend it by hand. So what I did was I got a, this is actually fuel line, it doesn't matter, 8-in fuel line with, fittings put on it, and I got a bulkhead fitting and drilled through the bottom of the floor, and so they have a nipple sticking on the bottom side of the car like it has to, so if your burst disc blows, it'll shoot all the nitrous down this tube and out of the car. The other thing, it's a little extra work. I was looking if I have a friend at a shop that has the gun for it, but he put Zerk nuts in the floor so I could thread, so it's a threaded hole fitting in the floor, and I just thread the bolts into it. The thing with that is, though, the left side is not so bad. The right side is kind of pain in the ass because it's on the frame rail. That's what, now where the nitrous line is and the purge is, they're straight out to the bottom of the car, but you gotta be careful. I mean, there's not much air, room for air here as far as mounting this thing. I wish they would have given you a better damn bracket to mount the bottle. They're kind of flimsy, especially until you get it mounted. Now I got this line here set up for my secondary bottle. I had to put the gauge in line that way because it doesn't have a fitting on the bottle like my other one does. And I'm playing with line size, and I'm probably gonna get another 90-degree adapter like I do my other bottle to. I can shorten the line and make it look cleaner. Like I said, the ball's not here right now, but just so you know, if you go to NHRA track, you have to have a blowdown tube. No exceptions. They will not let you run without this.